Yumi Chen here with another video. I know it's been a little while since I did a speed paint, but I'm actually running out of time to get this edited and put this up. So today's video is going to be another portfolio walkthrough. This portfolio basically has a lot of original character designs that I have done. And overall, I'm happy with them. They're really old. I've redone them since then. But I thought I would show you guys what I had originally come up with when it comes to certain characters. So let's jump right into it. Alright, so like I said, this is going to be a character walk, like a portfolio walkthrough. This one isn't as full as the other one. But it is full enough that I can show you guys. Because now I do rough sheets on a bigger paper so that I can get more details in and more information in about my characters. So these are way too small for my liking, but I still go back to them once in a while. So the first one is a Saya's original character sheet that I had done. And basically I had done three versions with her basic, with the trench coat, the colors, and then her school uniform. But I've upgraded this quite a bit. I am happy with what I was at that point. Like, you can see the hands are so bad. this was 2015, I think this starts in 2015. And then we got Kyo and Shoko, so their original character design. Again, this is basically the same thing that I had done with Saya for them. And then there's random pieces of art that I did of my characters, like Kyo and Saya. My art style has improved so much since this. This was for Valentine's Day in 2015. It was actually, I was trying to make a pun, and it says, "I say you look hot enough to eat." So there's some characters, some furry characters I have. I really need to redo this one because I totally forgot about her. But she's redone in one of my sketchbooks. Again, Kyo and Saya improved so much since then. This was 2016, so from 2015 to 2016, I had quite a bit of improvement, but not as much as I had hoped. And I really don't like the skin tones on these ones, mostly because they're usually lighter, and I didn't have a light skin tone at the time anymore. So I used what I had, and I really didn't like how it turned out. If you're wondering why these are so thick, they're called art boards, and they're great. So then there's this Miss Mizou. Miss Mizou is an old character of mine. I actually sold her design and character rights to a friend of mine because I don't connect with her anymore. And then there is Francis. Francis is being worked on as a rough sheet currently. He doesn't have one yet, but I have written out all his information, which means that I can actually jump into it and get him drawn out. I was actually really proud of this for 2016 because I felt like my art style wasn't where I wanted it to be, and I was starting to head in the direction that I was really happy with. Now we're jumping into 2017. Again, my art style changes. This is Shoko. I used some colored pencil in this one and a couple of them because I may look like I have a lot of Copic markers, but I actually don't have enough to be able to do the characters and the color schemes that I want. And then this one I was experimenting with doing blood because that is something that's going to be included in my manga quite often. So that's another character I adopted. This was one of my third pieces of my new persona, which is Frona Fox. I decided to draw her in permanent marker only. It was quite, it was fun. It was a little bit on the difficult side, but I thought it was really fun. Another one I adopted, this was my first design for D-Lop, actually. And the thing is, the character changes color and hair when I change my hair color, because I change my hair color regularly. And this was the original character. There's a lot of things that I have kept from this, there's a lot of things that I have changed as well. And I believe this is the last one. This one is a small piece of sari. I had done it for a my old commission sheet as an example for half body. I still like it. I wish I would have done a little bit better. I think I was practicing colored pencils for this one. So I think that is it for this. Yeah. Basically, I put any pieces of my characters that are loose in this. I actually have to go through my stuff because I think I have some more that I need to add to this. So yeah, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you hit the like and the subscribe button, as well as the bell to be notified. Make sure you leave a comment if you want to see some more of these types of videos. And also, make sure you head on over to my Twitch every Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays, where you can see me live streaming, as well as make sure you head on over to my Patreon, where you can support me and get some Patreon unique rewards. If you haven't already, make sure you head on over to my Ko-fi as well, where you can support me without getting any rewards if you just like what I do. And that's it for today. Yumi-chan here. Over and out.